Good morning, Trinity Christian Fellowship. It's great to see everyone here in person today. We are back indoors for the first time since mid-March of last year. That is something to celebrate. I know it's an emotional time. You know, we've spent a lot of time by ourselves over the past however many months. It's been challenging, but through it all, God has been there. Jesus has been there. Nothing about who Christ is or how we can have a relationship with him has changed. We still have our firm foundation, whether we're meeting indoors, outdoors, here, there. That part, that's all great, but Christ is still above it all. So with that, I invite everyone to stand. I'll give us an opening word of prayer, and then we'll get into a time of worship this morning. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the opportunity to worship you together indoors. Lord, thank you for the opportunities that we've had over this past pandemic period to grow in our relationships with you, both individually as we each seek to know you better and to walk with you, and then also together as your body, as we've figured out ways to still meet together outside, over the FM radio, on YouTube, all these different and creative ways that we can still worship you, that we can still declare your truth, that we can still learn about you from your word. Lord, thank you, God. You are a creative God. You who created everything. There's no end to the creativity that you have and the creativity that you can give us that enables us to continue to praise your name, God. And that's what we want to do this morning. Whatever our emotions are, excitement, anxiety, expectations, we lay those aside for now, and we focus on you, God. May your name receive all the glory and honor from what we're about to do. And may our hearts and minds align with your will this morning. Lord, please bless us as we bring our praises to you. Please bless Pastor Alvaro as he delivers your word to us this morning. Help it to stick in our hearts as we walk out the doors today. And Lord, thank you so much for your Holy Spirit that walks with us daily, for the forgiveness of our sins through your death on the cross, for our hope of heaven from your resurrection on the third day, Lord. We know all these things have come to pass, and there is still so much more that is yet coming. Lord, this time is for you. It is your name we praise. In your name we pray, Lord Jesus. Amen. Strength will rise. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. thinking about how we wanted to do this service now that we're back indoors, I thought, it's been a while since we've introduced a new song. And in a way, part of this last year has felt like survival mode. Like, we've done what we could, we've done what we needed to do, but it felt a little bit like survival mode. And now that we're back indoors, just seemed like it would be wonderful to be able to come out of survival mode and introduce a new song here. And this is one that's been very popular among worship teams nationwide, worldwide, over the past couple years. You may have heard it on Christian radio at some point or another. It's called Waymaker. And I do too. I hope the rest of you, if you're hearing it for the first time here, can fall in love with it as well, and the spirit of worship that it can help to evoke. So we're going to sing it. We'll have the words on the screen. If you already know it, feel free to sing along. If you're learning it for the first time, also feel free to sing along or not, whatever your preference is. We're going to go through that here and just worship the Lord with a new song. You are here moving in our midst.
You are here moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you.
You are here.
You are here working in this place. I worship you.
That is who you are.
never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, one more time, never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, way maker. Darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Amen. Praise be to you, Lord. Now I invite everyone to take their seats, and we'll have Ray give us a communion devotion this morning.
Good morning. As we come to communion this morning, I actually wanted to say something that's not directly on communion at first, and part of it is that after, as Phil mentioned, it's 15 months, a full 15 months since we met in here last. That seems amazing. And the thing that I am most grateful for is you're all healthy and here. And that's something to just thank God for. And I was thinking this past week, there's been so much said in the past year. I don't know, maybe some of you are much more gracious than I am with the different opinions that have been going around. But I found myself sometimes thinking, you know, what are they thinking? And other times thinking, I understand perfectly what they're thinking, I don't agree. And to me, I was reminded of the phrase this last week that Pastor Al uses sometimes when certain things come up. Very simple phrase. How many of you have heard him say, that's not what we're about? He's used that phrase to clarify some things sometimes. And I don't know about you, but to me, as much as I have opinions on everything, to me it's a relief to come here on a Sunday morning and know that I won't have to be ready to debate or argue or get in a confrontation about the government or about socialism or capitalism or regulations or freedom or taxes or anything else. Because that's not what we're about here. Those things are incredibly important, and they need to be worked on by people because they affect everybody, but not here. And I find it a real relief to know that when I come here, as far as I know, there are two things we're here for: to worship God and to lift up Jesus and honor him as our Lord and Savior. And everything beyond that can stay outside for right now, and we can relax, enjoy it. Enjoy the music, enjoy pastor's teaching, enjoy the fellowship, and put those things where they belong, because they do belong someplace, just not here. And so I'm looking forward to everybody coming back, showing up. No, it's not all normal yet, but we're getting there, and we can just enjoy being here together. And I'm looking forward to that, regardless of all my opinions this year. That's what I want to enjoy with you here, the fellowship and worshiping God. And as we come to something that really is important to us here, our communion, I was reminded of that verse where in the Last Supper, Jesus says, takes the bread and says, "This is my body broken for you." And I've always thought that word broken, what an understatement. Sounds like they're going to break his arm or keep him from doing something. I wonder what the disciples' reaction would have been if he had said, "You know what the Romans are capable of on torture? You know that? That's what's, and killing people? That's what's going to happen to me." He used a nice word to give them an idea, but it didn't encompass the scope at all of what happened to him. The torture, the crucifixion. And I'm just constantly amazed that for all the planning, it says that Jesus planned this with God before he even showed up, before the foundation of the world, knowing that something needed to be done for us. They planned it, and yet in that garden right before it, Jesus still said, "Can I get out of this?" He still was human enough to go, this is going to be bad. Can I get out of this? But it says in Hebrews, "For the joy set before us, for our salvation, for our forgiveness, for our joy, Jesus loved us enough to just go ahead with it, to say, it's horrible, but I love my people, my disciples, my followers. I love everyone who accepts me so much that I'll go through with it." And he did. And that's what we can be thankful for in communion today, that we have a Jesus who looked ahead, saw us, and said, "We're worth it, no matter what it takes." So I don't know if anybody brought in any communion. If you have any, please go ahead and get it out. Because Jesus did say at that Last Supper, he took the bread, he broke it apart. Because in Hebrew culture, you don't cut bread. Maybe you do now, I don't know. But back then, you never took a knife to bread. You didn't cut it. You broke it. You split it apart. He broke the bread and said, "This is my body broken for you." And he says, "Take, eat it, remembrance of me." And then he said, took the cup. And of course, completely opposite of anything we would do in COVID, passed it around to everybody. But passed around and said, "This is the blood, new covenant in my blood. And do this in remembrance of me." And we can be thankful that he went through with it for us, even though we didn't deserve it. We didn't even ask for it at that time. We weren't alive, but he did it for us. Let's pray. Lord, we do thank you for being here. We thank you above all that you are here, that you've ministered to us, that you've kept us in a condition that we can show up here today to enjoy your presence, enjoy your place, enjoy being together. We thank you so, Lord, for the gift of Jesus, the sacrifice of Jesus, the willingness to do something that was in absolutely no way for him, was all for us. We thank you and ask that we can continue our thanks and continue our awareness of that as we go throughout the week. In Jesus' name, amen. Christ.
Is the power of Christ in me, from life's first cry to final breath. Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand.
Go ahead and invite Pastor Alvaro to come up.
Gloria a Dios.
Praise God.
It's beautiful to get here today to worship God all together, right? Es maravilloso poder llegar hoy juntos a alabar al Señor.
It's beautiful that we're here together praising God.
And quiero decirle muchas gracias al worship team.
I want to thank the worship team.
Fue maravilloso poder entrar en la presencia del Señor.
It was a marvelous thing to get into the presence of God.
Ver el interés, la entrega, la pasión con lo que hacen.
To see the interest and the passion in the way that we worship God.
No sé si algunos de ustedes se dieron cuenta cómo estaban apasionados, concentrados.
I don't know if you guys even noticed how concentrated and passionate you guys were today.
Yo como pastor,
and I as a pastor,
lo primero que veo son los que están ministrando la alabanza.
The first ones I see are the ones ministering the worship.
Yo quiero que mi espíritu se fortalezca.
I want my spirit to be strengthened.
Y si el grupo de alabanza está inspirado en la presencia del Señor, yo soy inspirado.
And if the worship team is inspired by the Spirit of God, I'm also inspired.
So, los felicito.
I want to congratulate you.
Y sigan adelante.
And keep moving forward.
Si le podemos dar un fuerte aplauso a los del worship team.
If we can give a round of applause for the worship team.
También quiero agradecer por el privilegio que se me concede de poder hablar de la palabra del Señor.
And I also want to thank you guys for the privilege of being able to speak about God's word.
Quiero mandar un saludo al Pastor Brown, si nos está viendo, si nos va a ver.
I want to say hi to the pastor if he's watching us right now.
Que Dios lo bendiga y que Dios lo guarde en sus vacaciones.
May God bless him and keep him on his vacation.
Dios bendiga la congregación por mandarlo de vacaciones.
God bless the church for sending him on vacation.
Porque ustedes lo mandaron, ¿verdad?
You guys sent him, right?
¿Se imagina un año luchando con tantos pensamientos?
Can you imagine a whole year wrestling with so many thoughts?
¿Quién se va a morir? ¿Quién no se va a morir? ¿Quién va a regresar? ¿Quién no va a regresar?
Who will die? Who will live? Who will come back? Who won't come back?
Es una lucha tremenda, hermanos, a poder batallar con una situación de esta naturaleza.
It is a great struggle to fight against a situation like this.
Y hay muchas cosas que se nos olvidaron durante este año.
There's many things that we've forgotten during this year.
No sé si ustedes se acuerdan qué día es hoy.
I don't know if you guys remember what day it is today.
Father's Day, right? Happy Father's Day.
I
Vivimos en un mundo, vivimos en un país multicultural.
We live in a very multicultural country.
Hemos familias de diferentes países, diferentes lugares.
There's families from different countries and places.
Pero lo lindo es que llegamos a este lugar, como decía el hermano, que llegamos a este lugar y nos unimos en una misma cultura.
But the beautiful thing is that, like the brother said, that we come here to unite in one culture to praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Ese es el propósito de estar reunidos en esta mañana, de alabar y glorificar el nombre glorioso de nuestro Señor.
The purpose of us being here is to praise and worship God's name.
Pero creo que es un buen día.
But today's a beautiful day.
Es un buen día para no dejar el tema de lo que estamos viviendo.
To not leave the theme out of what we're living.
Y vamos a hablar de las características de un buen padre.
And we're going to speak about the characteristics of a great father.
Porque yo sé que hay buenos padres aquí.
Because I know there's good fathers here.
You got your father here, right? Hay buenos padres aquí.
There's good fathers here, right?
¿Cuántos buenos padres hay aquí?
How many of them are there?
Yo creo que es importante hablar de las características de un buen padre.
I think it's important to speak about a good father's characteristics.
Y como dije que venimos, vivimos en un país de muchas culturas.
And how I said that we live in a very multicultural country.
En nuestra cultura, de donde nosotros somos.
In our culture, where we're from.
Los padres estaban acostumbrados a proveer para la familia.
Fathers are used to providing for their family.
Llegamos a esta cultura donde la mamá también provee para la familia.
We've come to this culture where the mother also provides for the family.
Pero hoy es un día muy especial.
But today is a very special day.
Yo quiero pasar por aquí para felicitar a todos los papás.
I came here to congratulate all the fathers.
Este es un día en el cual muchas familias se reúnen para agradecer a su papá.
On this day, many families get together to thank their fathers.
Por todo lo bueno que ha sido.
For all the good or how good he's been.
Algunos reciben regalos.
Some get gifts.
No sé cuántos han recibido un regalo ya.
I don't know how many of you guys received gifts today.
Algunos se les olvidó comprar el regalo para papá.
Some forgot their parents, their father's gift.
Yo recibí el mío anoche.
I received mine last night.
Cuando me fui a acostar, mi nena de 7 años me dijo, Daddy, ve a la cama y te dejé algo especial para ti ahí.
When I went to bed, my daughter came over to me and said, Dad, I left a gift for you on the bed.
Pensé un par de zapatos.
I thought a pair of shoes, maybe.
Pero no, llegué y encontré una nota donde decía, Dad, I love you.
And I found a note that said, Dad, I love you.
Dad, I love you. Papi, te amo. Y decía, Happy Father's Day. Ese fue uno de los regalos más hermosos que un papá puede recibir.
That's one of the best gifts that a father can receive.
Más en estos tiempos donde... En estos tiempos donde la sociedad se ha corrompido tanto.
Especially in these times where the society is very corrupt nowadays.
La responsabilidad como padres es criar a nuestros hijos bajo normas y una buena cultura.
Our responsibility as fathers is to raise our children under good norms.
Nosotros nos enseñaron de que un hijo no podía decir una mala palabra en frente de sus padres.
They taught us that a child shouldn't say any bad words before their father, parents.
No podía contestarle a un papá.
They couldn't answer back to their parents.
No podía gritarle a una persona mayor.
They couldn't yell at any elders.
Esa es la cultura que nosotros
that is our culture.
Enseñaron a crecer como hijos.
How we were raised.
Y lo agradecemos.
And we thank that.
Pero hemos visto que hay culturas en las cuales los hijos han perdido el respeto para sus padres.
And we see that there's cultures where children have lost respect for their parents.
Por eso es que muchos hoy en día no reciben sorpresas, no reciben regalos, no reciben cariño, porque los hijos se han corrompido con las malas amistades.
That's why today a lot of parents don't get gifts or kindness from their own children because things are corrupt.
En el capítulo 15... El capítulo 15 de Lucas.
In Luke chapter 15.
Aquí encontramos una figura de un excelente padre.
We see a figure of an excellent father.
De quien como excelente nosotros podemos aprender algo importante.
From whose excellence we can learn something very important.
En este capítulo.
In this chapter.
Todos nos relacionamos con el hijo pródigo.
We all relate to the prodigal son.
Pero yo quiero olvidarme un poquito del hijo pródigo.
But I want to forget about him a little bit today.
Quiero enfocarme de la actitud del papá.
I want to focus on the attitude of his father.
Regularmente yo recuerdo que en nuestra cultura,
I remember that in our culture,
los hijos cuando cumplen 18, 19, 20, 21, 30, si no quieren irse de la casa no se van.
Children when they're 18, 20, 30, if they don't want to leave home, they don't leave home.
En diferentes culturas los niños cuando cumplen 18 años ya quieren salirse de la casa.
In different cultures when they're 18, they want to leave the home.
Cuando cumplen 21 años ya son libres, pueden hacer lo que ellos quieren.
When they're 21, they're free, they can do whatever they want.
Yo recuerdo que una vez le dije cumplí 18 años.
I remember when I turned 18.
No me hacía falta nada en mi casa.
I didn't need anything in my home.
Pero yo le dije a mi mamá y mi papá, yo me voy a ir de la casa.
But I told my parents, I'm going to leave home.
Porque sentía que tenía muchas responsabilidades.
Because I felt I had many responsibilities.
Tenía que levantarme a las 3 de la mañana para ordeñar 40 vacas.
I had to wake up at 3 in the morning to milk 40 cows.
No con máquina, pura mano.
By hand.
Después de las 7, de 3 a 7 de la mañana que terminaba, me tenía que ir a la escuela.
From 3 to 7, after that, I had to go to school.
Después que venía de la escuela, tenía que agarrar un tractor y irme a trabajar al campo con un tractor.
When I came home from school, I had to get a tractor and go work on the field.
No tenía tiempo de jugar con mis amigos.
I didn't have time to play with my friends.
Cuando cumplí 18 años, dije, me voy de la casa.
When I turned 18, I said, I'm leaving.
Mi mamá agarró una bolsa plástica.
My mom grabbed a plastic bag.
Me echó como dos o tres pantalones.
Gave me like two or three pairs of pants.
Y los puso afuera en la puerta de la casa.
And she put them outside the door of the house.
Y me dijo, ¿oí que te vas a ir?
I heard you were leaving.
Le dije, sí.
I said, yes.
Ahí está tu ropa.
There's your clothes.
Que te vaya bien.
Have a good time.
Cuando yo oí que me estaban diciendo que me fuera de la casa.
When I heard that they were telling me that I can leave.
Entonces reaccioné.
Then I reacted.
Nunca jamás mencioné esa palabra que me quería ir de la casa.
And never again did I say I wanted to leave the house.
En el capítulo 15.
In chapter 15.
Aquí encontramos la parábola del hijo pródigo.
We find the parable of the prodigal son.
Donde probablemente tenía 10. How old are you? You're 21, you look like 18. Encontramos a un muchacho que probablemente tenía 18 años.
We find a young man who's probably 18 years old.
Que le dijo a su papá, me quiero ir de la casa, dame lo que me pertenece.
Who told us that, I want to leave home, give me what
todos
belongs to me.
Todos conocemos esa historia, ¿verdad que sí?
We all know the story, right?
Y su papá no se lo negó como probablemente muchos buenos padres que le dan a sus hijos lo que les piden.
And his father didn't reject that. Like a lot of us fathers that give their kids what they want.
Porque hay padres que creen que dándole todo lo que los hijos piden eso es ser buen padre.
Because there's fathers that believe giving their children everything they want is being a good father.
Y yo creo que no es así.
And I believe that is not so.
Porque la Biblia dice que Dios a nosotros nos da lo que nosotros necesitamos.
Because the Bible teaches us that God gives us what we need.
No lo que nosotros queremos.
Not what we want.
Porque queremos muchas cosas.
Because we want a lot of things.
Los hijos a veces quieren zapatos de $400.
Our kids sometimes want $400 shoes.
Y lo que necesitan los pies son zapatos.
And what they need is just a regular pair of shoes.
Los zapatos no saben leer números.
Shoes don't know how to read numbers. Our feet don't know how to read numbers.
Pero los padres a veces se esfuerzan tanto que no tienen el cash para comprarlo, sino que compran con una tarjeta de crédito.
But they want to please them so much that sometimes when they don't even have cash, they pay with a credit card.
Y después se quedan pagando esos zapatos caros.
And then they're paying those shoes.
Creyeron o pensaron que dándole lo que su niño quería, eso era ser buen papá.
Because they thought giving them what their child wanted was being a good parent.
Este padre le dio a su hijo lo que le pidió.
This father gave his son what he asked for.
Pero lo que me llama la atención a mí, una de las características.
But what calls my attention, one of the characteristics.
Su padre nunca le cerró la puerta.
His father never closed the door.
En Lucas capítulo 15, verso 19 dice.
Luke chapter 15, verse 19 says.
Porque se dio cuenta que no era realmente lo que él pensaba.
He found out that it wasn't really what he thought it would be.
Porque fue a comer con los puercos.
He went to eat with the pigs.
Y se dio cuenta que le hacía tanta falta el cariño, la cobertura de su papá.
And he understood that he needed so much of his father's care.
Y él dijo, ya no soy digno de ser llamado tu hijo, hazme como a uno de tus jornaleros.
And he says, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of thy hired servants.
Y levantándose, dice el verso 20, vino a su padre y fue movido a misericordia y dice, y corrió y se echó sobre su cuello y le besó.
Verse 20, and he arose and came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him.
¿Usted sabe cuántas relaciones entre padre y hijo se han perdido?
Do you know how many relationships between father and child have been lost?
¿Usted sabe cuántos hijos han salido de la casa y nunca más han regresado?
Do you know how many kids have left their home and never came back?
Porque los padres muchas veces han sido tan duros y tan fuertes con ellos que les han cerrado la puerta para siempre.
Because their parents have been so strict and hard on them that they close the door on them forever.
Pero este padre de Lucas, de esta anécdota, este padre siempre estaba esperando a su hijo.
But this father in this parable was always waiting for his son.
¿Por qué? Porque dice que cuando lo vio de lejos.
Because it says when he saw him from afar.
El hijo venía arrepentido.
The son came repentant.
Pero el padre obviamente lo estaba viendo, esperando, que dice que corrió, lo abrazó y lo besó.
The father was obviously waiting for him because he ran to him, he hugged him, and he kissed him.
No importa cuál haya sido la causa por la que se había ido el hijo.
The cause doesn't really matter why he left.
¿Usted sabe cuántos hijos hoy viven ausentes de la casa de papá?
Do you know how many children today live absent from their father's home?
Porque perdieron una buena relación, perdieron una buena comunicación.
Because they lost a good relationship, a good communication.
Aquí es donde viene la importancia de las palabras.
This is where the importance of words comes.
Y quiero decirle que en nuestra cultura hispana,
and I want to say that in our culture,
padecemos de las buenas palabras. Sufrimos mucho por las buenas palabras.
We suffer a lot to give good words.
Nos enseñaron a trabajar.
They taught us how to work.
Nos enseñaron a ser independientes.
They taught us how to be independent.
Pero nunca nos dijeron cuánto nos amaba.
But they never told us how much they loved
Hablando
us.
En mi caso.
Speaking in my case,
yo nunca oí de mi papá decirme, hijo, te amo.
I never heard my father say, son, I love you.
Yo nunca recuerdo que mi papá alguna vez me haya dado un abrazo.
I never remember even one hug from my father.
Nunca recuerdo que mi papá me haya dado un beso.
I don't even remember a kiss.
Me gritaba.
He yelled at me.
Me pateaba.
He kicked me.
Y nos daba tantas otras cosas, pero nunca buenas palabras.
And gave me so many other things but good words.
Y ese es un fracaso en nuestra cultura hispana.
And that is a failure in Hispanic culture.
Pero cuando un hijo crece,
but when a son grows,
felicito a los hermanos que tienen a sus niños aquí en la iglesia.
And I congratulate the kids that have their children here.
Ellos van a crecer y van a aprender de esta anécdota.
They're going to grow and they're going to learn from this parable.
Probablemente los demás dicen, ah, eso ya me lo sé.
Many others say, I already know this.
Pero probablemente estos niños van a decir, recuerdo que un día del padre llegamos a la iglesia y el pastor Álvaro habló de las características de un buen padre.
And probably they'll say, I remember one Sunday on Father's Day, Pastor Álvaro spoke about the characteristics of a great father.
Es importante las palabras.
Words are very important.
¿Por qué? Porque cuando nosotros o cuando los hijos toman la decisión de salir de su casa, que todos vamos a salir de casa, todos hemos salido de casa.
Because when the children make that decision to leave home, because we all leave home.
¿Qué es lo que va a escuchar ese muchacho o esa muchacha cuando se va?
What will that child or boy or girl listen when they leave?
Es importante que escuchen esa palabra, te vas, pero recuerda que siempre te estaré esperando.
It's important for them to hear, you leave, but I'll always be waiting for you.
Porque nosotros crecimos, nos enamoramos, nos casamos.
Because we grew up, we fell in love, we got married.
Y nos fuimos.
And we left.
Con excepción de mi esposa.
With exception of his wife.
Mi esposa tenía 37 años cuando se casó conmigo.
His wife was 37 when she married him.
37 años y vivía en la casa de su papá y su mamá todavía.
37, living with her dad and mom.
Y le voy a contar algo aquí en secreto.
And I'll tell you a secret.
Cuando yo me casé con esta muchacha, no solamente vivía en su casa, sino que guardaba su virginidad.
I married this woman. Not only did she live at home, but she kept her virginity.
¿Por qué? Porque fue criada en una cultura donde se enseña y se practica esta situación.
Because she grew up in a culture where they practice this situation.
Y la Biblia dice que el que se casa, casa quiere.
The Bible says that whoever gets married wants a home.
Pero cuando yo le dije que me quería casar con ella.
But when I told her I wanted to get married.
Ella vivía solamente con su mamá porque su papá se había separado.
She only lived with her mother because her parents had separated.
Yo me caso contigo,
she said, I will marry you.
Pero no quiero dejar a mi mamá.
But I don't want to leave my mother.
Yo adopté a su mamá como mi mamá.
And I adopted her mother as my mother.
Un día.
One day.
Un día mi suegra me dijo, yo creo que me voy a buscar dónde yo irme.
My mother-in-law said, I will look for a place to go.
Y yo le dije, procure buscar un lugar un poquito grande para irnos todos con usted.
And I said, look for a big place so we can all go with you.
Es importante las palabras.
Words are important.
Te vas, pero recuerda que siempre te estaré esperando.
You leave, but remember, I will always be waiting for you.
Si algún día mi hijo o mi hija decide regresar, ahí está tu cuarto, o ahí está tu sala, tu closet, tus zapatos.
If one day you decide to return, there's the room, the closet, the living room, your shoes.
Pero hay padres que han usado la palabra, si te vas, recuerda que me pierdes como padre.
But some parents say, if you leave, you lost a parent.
Y antes de irse,
and before they leave,
qué lindo sería que escuchara de su papá, te amo.
How beautiful it would be to hear the words, I love you.
Y eres muy especial.
And you are very special.
Es más, cuando naciste,
that when you were born,
la nena, ¿cómo se llama su nena? ¿Qué le dijo usted cuando la vio por primera vez?
What did you say when you saw her the first time?
I love you. Te amo. Es más, cuando naciste, creí que eras la persona más hermosa de todo el universo.
When you were born, I believe you were the most beautiful person in the universe.
Pero ahora entiendo que has crecido, te tienes que ir.
But I understand that you've grown up and you have to leave.
Dios te bendiga.
God bless you.
Te amo y siempre te estaré esperando.
I love you and I'll always be waiting for you.
Probablemente eso fueran las palabras que el hijo pródigo escuchó de su papá.
That's probably what the prodigal son heard from his father.
Por eso él decidió regresar a su casa.
That's why he decided to return home.
Usted no sabe cuántos hijos probablemente están pensando regresar a la casa de su papá porque probablemente no pueden pagar la renta.
You can think about how many kids want to go back to their parents' house because they can't pay rent.
Yo conozco familias o conozco padres que viven solos en una casa de 4 o 5 cuartos.
I know parents that live in a big house with 4 or 5 rooms alone.
Con hijos que viven rentando el cuarto de un vecino.
With children that live renting the neighbor's room.
Porque la casa de su papá se cerraron las puertas para ellos.
Because the doors of the parents' home was closed to them.
Porque nunca escucharon una palabra, cuando quieras regresar, puedes regresar.
Because they never heard that word, you can come back when you want to.
Un buen padre ama.
A good father loves.
Un buen padre ama.
A good parent loves.
Dice que corrió.
It says that he ran.
El entusiasmo y el gozo del padre por su hijo.
The joy and enthusiasm of the father for his son.
A mí me encanta ver a los hijos que caminan con su papá.
I love to see the kids that walk with their father.
Me encanta ver a las hijas que van y abrazan a su papá.
I like to see the daughters that go and hug their father.
Ahora con eso de la distancia social, como que andan un poquito separados, ¿verdad?
And now with social distancing, they're a little far apart.
Pero me encanta ver, hermano, cuando las familias son unidas.
But I love to see united families.
Me encanta ver a un padre que encamina a su hijo y que lo instruye en el camino.
I love to see a father that instructs his child.
Y que le enseña cómo adorar a Dios.
And teaches him how to worship God.
Me gusta ver a una familia que agarran a sus hijos y dice, vamos a la casa del Señor.
I like to see the family that takes all
porque
their kids
to church. Porque
esa es
la única herencia que un padre puede darle a sus hijos.
That's the only thing we can give the,
a
our
los
kids,
nietos.
Our grandkids.
Pero muchas veces nosotros tomamos la decisión Ya son grandes, you can do whatever you want.
Many times.
Oh, sorry.
Many times we take the decision, you're older, you can do whatever you want.
No tiene que ser así.
It doesn't have to be that way.
Yo soy tu padre.
I'm your father.
Y como le dice mi esposa a mis hijas.
And like my wife tells my daughters.
Aunque tengan mil años.
Even if you're 1,000 years old.
Voy a ser su madre.
I'll be your mother.
Y aunque les tope la cabeza al cielo de la casa.
And if your head is touching the roof of the house.
Si no se portan bien, se la van a ver conmigo.
If you don't behave, you'll regret it.
Esa es la cultura hispana.
That's Hispanic culture.
No importa cuántos años tengas.
Doesn't matter how old you are.
No importa qué viejo sea.
Doesn't matter how old you are.
Yo seré tu padre y seré tu madre.
I will be your father and your mother.
Aquí donde estés.
Wherever you're at.
Y me vas a respetar.
And you will respect me.
Porque la Biblia dice.
Because the Bible says.
Que honra a su padre, a sus padres, dice que Dios le prolonga de muchos años.
He who honors his parents, God will give him a long life.
Entonces bíblico, ¿verdad que sí?
That is a biblical principle.
Entonces este hombre corrió y eso me llama la atención. Ya estoy redondeando, ¿okay?
This man ran and that called my attention. I'm almost finishing it.
Este padre corrió al encuentro de su hijo.
He ran to meet his child.
Yo no sé cuántos padres han deseado volver a abrazar a sus hijos.
I don't know how many of you desire to hug your children again.
Yo no sé cuántos padres recuerdan cuándo fue la última vez que abrazaron a su hijo.
I don't know what was the last time you guys hugged your child.
Y que anhelan y que desean volverlo a hacer.
And that you desire to do it again.
No deje que pase el tiempo.
Don't let time pass.
Si su hijo no le ha llamado, si su hijo no le ha visitado, agarre el teléfono.
If your children haven't called.
Dígale, mi hijo, te amo tanto.
You call him.
Te extraño y quisiera volverte a abrazar.
And tell him, I miss you, I love you, and I want to hug you again.
¿Usted sabe el poder de esas palabras?
Do you know the power of those words?
¿Usted sabe que las palabras construyen grandes relaciones?
You know that words construct great relationships?
Pero también destruyen grandes relaciones.
But they also destroy great relationships.
Las palabras tienen tanto poder.
Words have so much power.
Que es importante que nosotros las practiquemos cada día.
That we must practice them every day.
Este padre no solamente corrió, lo abrazó, sino que dice que lo hizo, le dio el valor que él tenía.
Not only did he run and hug them, but he gave them the valor that he had.
Lo perdonó.
He forgave them.
¿Usted sabe cuánto falta de perdón hoy en día?
You know how much unforgiveness there is these days?
¿Usted sabe cuánta falta de perdón de hoy en día?
There's so much unforgiveness in these days.
Este padre no solamente ama a su hijo que se había portado mal, porque este muchacho se portó mal.
Not only did he love his child that was very badly behaved.
Probablemente merecía ser castigado.
He probably deserved punishment.
Pero más sin embargo lo ama y también lo perdona.
But he loved him and he forgave him.
El verso 22 dice, pero el padre dijo a sus siervos, saquen el mejor vestido, vístanle y pónganle un anillo en su mano y calzado en sus pies.
Verse 22. But the father said to his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet.
Si notamos el hijo,
if we notice the son,
no alcanzó a decir el discurso que había preparado para decírselo a su papá.
He didn't even have a chance to give his father an explanation.
Porque en el verso 17, 18, 18, él había dicho, me voy a levantar, voy a ir con mi papá y le voy a decir esto, esto y esto.
Because if you notice in verse 17 and 18, he speaks about how he will get up and he will go to his father and he will explain everything that happened.
Él pensó lo que le iba a decir a su papá.
He thought what he was going to tell his father.
Pero su papá ni siquiera lo dejó expresar ni siquiera una sola palabra.
But his father didn't even need an explanation.
No alcanzó a decir el discurso de arrepentimiento.
He didn't even have a chance to repent towards his father.
¿Por qué? Porque su padre lo estaba esperando.
Because his father was waiting for him.
Yo quiero en esta tarde, en esta mañana todavía.
In this morning, I want
dejarles saber a ustedes.
To let you know.
Que la relación de un buen padre con su hijo,
that a relationship with a good father with his child,
vale la pena,
is worth it.
Recuerdo que en una oportunidad escuché de una familia donde vivía el abuelo en casa.
I remember when I heard about a family that had the grandfather at home.
El abuelo le temblaba la mano, se le caían los vasos.
The grandfather's hand shook, he dropped glasses.
La comida la regaba en la mesa.
He spilled his food on the table.
De tal manera que el hijo decidió decirle a su papá que ya no podía comer más junto con ellos.
In such manner that he told his the son told his father that he couldn't eat with them no longer.
Le dijo, tú vas a comer solo y en una mesa sin mantel, y le compró un plato de madera y un vaso de madera.
He said, you're going to eat by yourself at a table by yourself, and he bought him a wooden plate and a plastic and a wooden cup.
Su hijo pequeño,
the small son,
miró lo que su papá estaba haciendo con su abuelo.
Saw what his father was doing with his grandfather.
Un día le dijo que encontró un pedazo de madera y comenzó a labrar el pedazo de madera el niño.
The boy found a piece of wood and started working on it.
Y su papá le preguntó, ¿qué estás haciendo?
The father asked him, what are you doing?
Le dice, estoy haciéndote tu plato y tu vaso para cuando ya estés viejo.
He said, I'm making you a plate and a cup for when you're older.
Desde ese día en adelante, el padre le dijo al abuelo, tú vuelves a comer con nosotros en la mesa.
From that day forward, the father told the grandfather, you will eat with us again.
No importa que botes el agua.
Doesn't matter if you spill the water.
No importa que no puedas comer, yo te voy a alimentar.
And even if you can't eat, I will feed you.
¿Por qué? Porque se dio cuenta.
Because he understood.
Lo que su hijo se estaba dando cuenta.
What his child was understanding.
Y la Biblia dice que nosotros cosechamos lo que sembramos.
And the Bible says that we reap what we sow.
En nuestra cultura, termino con esto.
And I finish with this. In our culture,
casi no existen los asilos de ancianos.
There isn't elderly homes.
¿Por qué? Porque el abuelo.
Why? Because the grandfather
vive en la casa con sus hijos hasta que se muere.
Lives with the children until he dies.
En este país me ha tocado encontrarme, he tenido que visitar muchos asilos de ancianos.
In this country, I've visited many convalescent homes.
Donde hay padres que me han dicho que tienen uno, dos y hasta tres años que ni siquiera un familiar los ha visitado.
Where the fathers say that it's been two or three years that one family member hasn't visited them.
Algunos de ellos que están conscientes les he preguntado, ¿cuál fue su relación con sus hijos?
And I've asked them, the ones that are conscious, what was your relationship with your son?
Les di todo lo que necesitaba.
I gave him everything he needed.
Les compré una casa a cada uno.
I bought each and every one of them a home.
Les dejé cuenta bancaria a cada uno.
I left them bank accounts.
Y les he preguntado, ¿alguna vez los abrazó?
And I asked them, did you ever hug them?
¿Alguna vez les dio un beso?
Did you kiss them?
¿Alguna vez lo llevó al parque a jugar?
Did you play with them at the park?
Me dijo, nunca tuve tiempo para esas cosas.
They said, I never had time for that.
Porque siempre estaba trabajando.
Because I was always working.
La consecuencia de lo que sembró.
The consequence of what he
ahora está
reaped,
cosechando la soledad.
That's what he sowed.
Es importante entonces, hermanos, de que nosotros trabajemos en una buena relación como padres con nuestros hijos.
It's important that we work on a relationship between fathers and children.
Porque miramos que en esta historia,
because we see that in this story,
muchos de nosotros representamos a ese hijo pródigo.
Many of us represent that prodigal son.
Y este padre representa a nuestro padre celestial.
And this father represents our heavenly father.
Nosotros muchas veces nos hemos alejado de Dios.
Many times we've drifted away from God.
Pero más sin embargo, él siempre nos está esperando.
But he's always been waiting for us.
Siempre está con los brazos abiertos.
His arms are always open.
Y si Dios está siempre esperándonos a nosotros con los brazos abiertos.
And if God is always waiting for us with his arms open.
¿Quiénes somos nosotros para no perdonar a nuestros hijos?
Who are we not to forgive our children?
¿Quiénes somos nosotros para no darles una oportunidad a nuestros hijos?
Who are we not to give them opportunity?
Así es de que en esta tarde yo quiero una vez más darles las felicitaciones a todos los padres.
So on this day I want to congratulate all the fathers.
Y que tomen algunas de las buenas características del padre del hijo pródigo.
And to take these good characteristics of the father of the prodigal son.
Amen a sus hijos.
Love your children.
Respeten a sus hijos.
Respect your children.
perdonen a sus hijos.
Forgive your children.
Yo sé que muchos hijos,
I know many children,
hemos tomado algunas decisiones muy equivocadas,
have taken very bad decisions.
Pero necesitamos a alguien que nos,
but we need somebody,
que nos detenga y que nos dé la mano para salir adelante.
That holds us up and gives
muchos
us a hand.
Muchos hijos que han caído en hoyos profundos.
Many of our children have fallen
no
in
saben
deep pits.
Salir.
They don't know how to get
están
out.
Esperando que su padre lo levante.
And they're waiting for the father to get them out.
Así que en esta tarde, en esta mañana, Dios les bendiga, Dios les fortalezca y les dé sabiduría a todos los padres.
May God bless you in this morning and give you wisdom.
Y espero que cuando regresen a casa los estén esperando con una fiesta a sus hijos.
And I hope that when they return home, there's a party at your house.
Bendiciones a todos. God bless you.
God bless you all.
Who's going to take over?